Mr. Excel podcast sponsored by Easy Excel. Our Excel for Mr. Excel podcast episode 1718, unique color for each unique value. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, after that holiday weekend in the United States, we're back here on Tuesday. I want to send out congratulations to my youngest son, Zeke, who graduated from high school, and my father, Bob, who turned 91 yesterday. I had a big party. People were in from all over. I never got to a podcast, Memorial Day podcast, but we're back here on Tuesday with a question from Mansoor. How can I assign unique colors to every unique value within that column? So, you know, you put in HV22220, comes up with one color. Type another value, get another color. Type another value, get another color. But then you go back and type the same value that appeared before, it gets the same color as the previous. All right. So this is going to be a macro, obviously, and some things to think about. We want this to work in one particular column. So I'm just going to randomly choose here column 3. And when data gets entered in some row, so let's say that we enter data here, think about what we have to do. We have to look at that value that just got entered and then do a match, equal match, and go look from C1 to C, well, over here, I say that's N minus 1, but C1 colon C4. So we're going to look above us and see if the value that was just entered is there. And if it was there, hey, we're done. Find that row, copy the interior fill color down to this row. But if it's not, then we have to assign a color. And this can get really difficult, figuring out what color to assign. Now, today, I'm just going to randomly choose a red value, a green value, a blue value, and send it to the RGB function. So I'm going to choose a number between 0 and 255 using ran between. But all of this is going to happen in the VBA window. To get to VBA, we press Alt F11. Over here in the Project Explorer, if you don't see the Project Explorer, go to View, Project Explorer, or Control R. You're going to look for this workbook. You're going to find Sheet 1 and double click Sheet 1. Top left drop down, there's only one thing to choose. Choose Worksheet. And they automatically choose Selection Change. Now, that's not what we want. We want to create a macro that runs every time that we change the worksheet. All right, so we can actually get rid of this tiny little macro they created. They create the beginning and end for us. Although I've already written this and it's on the clipboard, so I'm just going to press Control V. And we're going to talk about this one thing at a time. Okay, so remember I said that I am eventually going to use a match, and I'm going to use ran between, ran between, ran between. So we actually have a situation where I'm using four different worksheet functions. And normally, we would have to do something like x equals application.worksheetFunction.match. And that simply is a lot to type, especially four times. So there's a trick. I don't know where I learned this trick from, but I saw someone use this trick. You can actually create an object variable called WF. You can call it whatever you want. This stands for worksheet function, and set WF equal to application.worksheetFunction. And then once we've done that, I don't have to type application.worksheetFunction.match. I can just say x equals WF.match and go ahead and type everything. So it's just, think of it as a shorthand way. I'm too busy, lazy, to type application.worksheet function over and over and over again. Okay, now, this is a special kind of macro called an event handler macro. And when this fires, it fires every time that someone has changed a cell in this worksheet, they pass us a variable called target. And target is an object variable that says what cell just changed. And the thing I want to be careful of is I don't want this to run if someone comes here and clears a bunch of cells, or you know, types 1, 2, 3, enter. I don't know how to deal with that. So right now, it's only good for creating a single value. So the first thing we do: target that range that just changed, the number of cells dot count. If it's equal to 1, then we keep going. Otherwise, we just let the macro not end. And then check the target.column. Are we in column C? Column C is 1, 2, 3, the third column. Then we keep going. Otherwise, the macro ends. And we learned this actually on last Thursday's podcast. If you're going to do a match and the value is not found, it's going to throw an error, which stops your macro. So I'm going to avoid that with on error resume next. But the match won't get reset. So we have to reset the variable to 0 and then do the match. All right? And we're going to look for the target.value. That's the value we just typed. We're going to start in C1 and we're going to resize that down to the target.row. Remember, target is a cell that just changed. So if we just change cell C99, target.row will be 99 minus 1, gets us to 98. And then always end our match with a 0, which is like using false in VLOOKUP, saying we want an exact match. Now I reset that error handler back to the normal operation. That's called on error go to 0. And then check if x is greater than 0. Ah, great. This value has already been typed. The interior.color of the target cell, the cell that just changed, is the same as the value in row x, column 3, interior color. Now the 3 here and the 3 here is because I'm working in column C. The x was the result of the match. Easy, right? And actually, then I really started to think about, boy, choosing a new color. Do we have a big, huge list of colors that we want to use? Or, you know, for today, I'm just going random, which doesn't have the best results. Sometimes we get really dark colors. You might get two colors that are the same. RGB is a great function. You pass a number from 0 to 255 for red, for green, for blue. So I used application.worksheet function, but I didn't have to type the whole thing because I've already set up that object variable WF means application.worksheet function and used RAM between. All right, so all of this is here. We'll switch back to Excel. And if I go to any other column and type a value, nothing happens, right? Because it's not in the third column. If target.column is not equal to 3, then nothing happens. But here. Okay, so we type HV 22220, and we randomly get a color. And every time that I would do this, I'm going to get a different random color. All right, we'll do ABC 123, new color. GHI 987, new color. Although, see, those colors are similar. That's what makes me think maybe we should come up with some, you know, list of colors that we should loop through, or, you know, I don't know. Do we use the old the 56 colors from Excel 2003 that are stored in the workbook? I don't know. I'm not sure. But now when we go back and we type ABC 123, it does the worksheet event handler does the match, and it sees that it's already been used, HV 2220, and it uses the color. Let's type something else, RTY 123, and we get a new color. Repeat ABC 123, the old color comes back. All right, now, you know, one of the gotchas here, every time that you run a macro, it clears the undo stack. When you have a worksheet event handler running, well, every time that we type something in this worksheet, it's going to clear the undo stack. So you effectively are killing undo when you use this method. But if you have a particular need, this might be a good way to go. You know, to avoid that, rather than have a worksheet event handler, you could type all the values and then run a macro that would go through and analyze one cell at a time. But for Mansoor here, this seems to be a good way to go. And actually for anyone, even if you don't have this problem, a good tip today is just if you're using application.worksheet function over and over and over again, set it to an object variable, set WF is equal to application.worksheet function, and it'll save you some time as you go through. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast. Mr. Excel.